Good day, viewers. My name is Kunlade Tola. I'm the pastor of Fountain of Life, a parish of the Redeemed Christian Church of God based in Welling Garden City in the United Kingdom. It's my honor to present to you the Open Heavens Reflection today based on the Open Heavens Daily Guide written by Pastor E.A. Adeboye, the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. The topic before us today is Scatter to Increase. Our Bible passage is taken from Proverbs chapter 11, verse 23 to 25. The desires of the righteous is only good, but the expectation of the wicked is wrath. There is one who scatters, yet increases more. There is one who withholds more than is right, but it leads to poverty. The generous soul will be made rich, and he who waters will also be watered himself. Our memory verse is taken from Proverbs chapter 11, verse 24. There is one who scatters, yet increases more. There is one who withholds more than is right, but it leads to poverty. Our reflection. In the world system, what makes sense is to hold all that you have close to your chest so that you will become rich. The Bible calls this storing up treasures on the earth. In the kingdom of God, it is he who gives that becomes rich. We need to see our time and resources as seeds that we scatter so as to reap a harvest. A farmer does not eat all his crops. He will keep his best to sow, believing that he will reap a better harvest. A wise business owner will invest their profit in order to grow their business larger. This means that the higher you want to sow in life, the more seed you must sow. Ecclesiastes chapter 11 verse 6 says, "Plant your seed in the morning and keep busy all afternoon, for you don't know if profit will come from one activity or another, or maybe both." Galatians chapter 6 verse 9 says, "Let us not be weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not." Sometimes we get tired of sowing and give up too early. But as we are learning today, we don't know which seed will reap the highest harvest. Perhaps you are tiring in evangelism. Do you know whether the next soul you win for God could be the employer you've been looking for or the investor you need for your business? In Genesis chapter 26 from verse 8 to 15, we read that Isaac sowed in famine and reaped a hundredfold the same year. The first lesson from this is that there is a level of sacrifice involved in sowing. Also, whether the land is fertile or not does not affect you as a believer. Isaac sowed in a famine and yet he still reaped a hundredfold harvest. Pastor Adeboye specifically mentioned the importance of scattering in the Open Heavens Daily Guide of today. To be able to have in abundance, hoarding can never be the solution. When you scatter, you are increasing the avenue where you can reap. Believe the Lord today and scatter your seed, and you will find that you will have multiple harvests. Our action point. When you want to scatter your seed, start with the needy members of your local church. The Lord bless you. Have a wonderful day. Bye for now.